Question number 14. It is based on paramagnetism, that is Curie's law in magnetism and matter. Susceptibility is inversely proportional to absolute temperature. That is, this you can directly write I2 by I1 is equal to B2 by B1 into T2 by T1. Temperatures are given 4K and 16K, and is asking I2. I1 is given as 8, and B1 is given as 0.6, B2 is given as 0.2. Just substitute, you will get the answer. Now to find I2, I1 is given as 8 susceptibility, 8. Next, B2 is given as 0.2 by 0.6. T2 is 16 by 4. Then find I2. Next, question number 15. It is direct question from NCERT example question. Direct. There is a long cylindrical wire of radius R carries a uniform current I following through it. The variation of magnetic field with distance R from the axis of the wire is shown. So this is a direct NCERT test book question in Ampere's law. Ampere circuital law, immediately after Ampere circuital law, there is one example question. That is, there will be a solid wire. It is similar to Gauss law, how electric field varies in a solid sphere. From center to surface, how magnetic field varies? From center to surface, it is proportional to R. After crossing the surface, it is proportional to 1 by R. If it is solid sphere, if it is hollow sphere, from center to surface, 0, because there is no current. Just like Gauss law, by seeing this, you can understand. Next, based on cyclotron. Next question, last year also you got one question from cyclotron. There was one question from cyclotron last year also. Similarly, this year also has given. He has taken a alpha particle and it is its mass is given. Charge is given 2, mass is given 4. Proton it is given as H11. Next, deuteron H21. Now you know the radius of the circular path is mv by qb. Okay, this I can write it as momentum by qb. Okay, that is equal to R. Momentum is equal to QB into R. And kinetic energy is equal to P square by 2M. So kinetic energy I can write it as Q square B square R square by 2M. This is formula for kinetic energy in cyclotron. Substitute Q and B. They are under same condition, similar conditions is telling, and which one will have minimum kinetic energy is asking. So you have to eliminate R also from this, because R is not there in the problem. So you can eliminate R. If you want to eliminate R directly, what you can write, kinetic energy you can take half mv square. V you can write Q square B square R square by 2M. So here mass is given, kinetic energy is given. Otherwise, calculate the radius of each particle. Each particle radius is proportional to mass M by Q, and kinetic energy is proportional to R square. So from that you can write kinetic energy is half mv square. So what you can take here, each particle each particle radius is proportional to r is proportional to r is proportional to m by q. Take r1 by r2, if radius is more, kinetic energy is more, because in that is the principle of cyclotron. For each and every revolution, radius increases. When radius increases, kinetic energy also increases. So calculate whose radius is more. Okay, they all are entering with same velocity because they are moving under same condition. Means velocity, initial entrance velocity is same, and magnetic field is also same. So if r is more, kinetic energy is more. So directly you will get the answer. R is proportional to m by q. Kinetic energy is directly proportional to r square. That is the principle behind the rotation of the charged particle in a cyclotron. So next question, question number 17 is based on electromagnetic induction. Question number 17 is based on electromagnetic induction. When a rod is moving inside a magnetic field, EMF induced is equal to BLV sin theta. And EMF, you can write it as current into resistance, that is BLV. Then he is asking current I is equal to BLV by R. Just substitute, you will get the answer. Here R is given, rod of length, speed, length is given, B is given as 0.04, length is given as 2, V is given as 5, divided by R value is 3. Just divide, you will get the answer. As question number 18, a ratio of magnetic field at the center of current carrying circular coil to the magnetic moment is x. See, this is also very easy question, but it is little bit tricky. Magnetic moment by magnetic field, ratio of magnetic field to magnetic moment. So B by magnetic moment, or you take it as M, capital M, magnetic moment. B by M is equal to X. Then what the formula you will get for B by M? It is circular coil, mu naught Ni by 2R circular coil, divided by what is magnetic moment of circular coil? I into pi R square, I into area. Current into area is magnetic moment. So it is proportional to, I and I will get cancelled. It is proportional to, this ratio x is proportional to, x is proportional to n by r cube you will get, where n is number of turns, r is the radius. So from that you can, if current and radius both are doubled, it is proportional to current, it is not proportional to current, because current getting cancelled here. So it is independent of current, radius are doubled. Radius is doubled means radius increases by 2 times means x decreases by 8 times. X decreases by 8 times. That is the answer. So in question, he has given current also, but current is not required. In a permanent magnet at room temperature, this is also a point in NCERT. If you read your NCERT textbook very clearly, this question paper is very simple. In a permanent magnet at room temperature, magnetic moment domains are partially aligned. It is clearly given in your textbook. Next, in a given circuit, the resonance frequency, he has given one circuit and is asking the resonance frequency. The given circuit, the resonance frequency is possible when omega L is equal to 1 by omega C, then only you will get resonance. So omega square is equal to 1 by LC, and omega is equal to 1 by root LC, 2 pi by T is equal to 1 by root LC. And then you can calculate, L is given, C is given. Just you substitute, you will get the, he is asking frequency, means 2 pi n is equal to 1 by root LC. Next, the current in a coil changes from 5 amperes to 2 amperes. Current in a coil changes from 5 amperes to 2 amperes in 0.5 second. EMF induced, very simple question, minus L di by dt, direct self-inductance EMF formula. Current is changing from 5 to 2, so L value is given 0.2 into 5 minus 2 divided by time taken is 0.5 seconds, very simple question. And next question number 23, see based on LCR circuit every year you are getting one question in KCET examination. So this in LCR he has given three potential difference, potentials across resistor, potential across inductor and potential across capacitor are given. So if you draw the phasor diagram, inductor and capacitor will be exactly opposite, potential across inductor, potential across capacitor, VL and VC, they are opposite, this is VR. So effective potential difference is equal to root of V square plus VL difference of VC whole square. So just to apply you will get the answer, that is VL C and LR 110 minus 30 whole square plus 60 whole square, you will get 100 volts. Next question number 24. Refractive index of a prism is equal to mu is equal to sin a plus d by 2 by sin a by 2. This is the formula. And refractive index he has given cot a by 2. That means I can write this as cos a by 2 by sin a by 2. This is also direct question which is there in your NCRT test book. If a student is perfect in NCRT test book, this KCET exam which was conducted today is very easy by sin a by 2. This sin a by 2 and sin a by 2 will get cancelled. Cos a by 2 I can write it as sin 90 minus a by 2. Sin 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta. Then from that you can get d value as 180 minus 2a. Just solve it. If I am not correct, you will get cos a by 2 you write, sin 90 minus a by 2 you write, then you will get the answer. Very simple, within two steps. Next, momentum impart, what is the momentum imparted? Is nothing but momentum imparted on a perfectly reflecting surface. This is there in electromagnet waves. You can see in your textbook it is there. Momentum impart is equal to, if it is non-reflecting it is I into A, if it is reflecting it is 2 into I into A. Just substitute, you will get the answer. Side area is given 25 into 15 into 20. 25 into 15 into 20 will be the answer. 25 into 15 into 20. You convert everything in SI system, you will get the answer. Next question. Yes, this is also very good question. See, here this is a very good question which is asked in your question today, question paper. See, an object approaches a converging lens. An object is approaching a converging lens. Is approaching. It stops at focus. It is stopping at focus. So what happens to the image? If object approaches, image moves away with same speed, with the speed of uniform speed of 5 meter per second. So when it approaches with a uniform speed of 5 meter per second and it is stopping at focus, so if it stops at focus, what happens? So from 2f to f, the image moves faster than the object, from 2f to f. That means there, because both will have same velocity at 2f because size of the object is equal to size of the image at 2f. From 2f to f, what happens to size of the image? Size of the image from 2f to f, it decreases or increases. So therefore, speed increases from 2f to f. So from that you can answer that it is moving with non-uniform acceleration. Next, question number 27. This is based on resolving power. Resolving power is given as 1 minute. Resolving power is given as theta is given as 1/60 degrees is equal to this. You can convert into radians, pi by 180 into 1/60. Now L is equal to r theta. Then theta is given there. What is asking you is, is asking r. L is given as 3.4, so r is equal to 3.14 divided by pi by 180 into 60. This is answer. So that you will get nearly 10.8 kilometers. Next question, question number 28. The following figure shows a beam of light converging at point P when a concave lens of focal length 16 centimeters introduced in path of the beam at place shown by dotted line. Then beam converges at distance x. Beam converges at a distance x, then the value of x will be. So focal length is given 16. Beam convergence at distance x means is indirectly asking image distance. This is direct question actually. Instead of asking image distance, he told that beam converges at a distance x. When a reflected or refracted rays are converged, it is called image. So image distance is asking. So very simple question. 1/f is equal to 1/v. It is a lens. So 1/v minus 1/u. This is the formula. So focal length is converging, he has given. So it will get minus 1/16. Is equal to minus 1/16 is equal to 1/v and 1/v minus 1/12. To solve this you will get the answer. V is equal to, you will get 48 centimeters. Solve this, you will get V is equal to 48 centimeters. Your object is towards right side. You can observe the figure, object is towards right side. Next, question number 29. Question number 29. Two polaroids P1 and P2, totally three are there. First P1 and P2 are aligned at 45 degrees. This is P1, this is P2. And intensity of light coming out is equal to I is equal to I naught by 2 cos square phi, where phi is the angle. So 128 is I naught and theta is 45. Just take this as I1. And then afterwards this I1 is incident on P3 whose angle is also 45. So next, total light coming out is equal to I1 cos square phi. I1 cos square phi. Because this is already polarized. So I1 cos square phi will be the answer. So here first you calculate I1, then again calculate I1 you take and find cos square phi, you will get I value. This is the condition. Next, question number 30. The following graph represent variation of photo current with anode potential of metal surface I1 and I2 and I3. Here you can observe the answer is I1 frequency 1 is equal to frequency 2. I1 I2